This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA.
Welcome back to Spindling and the tutorial Striped. For this tutorial, you will need two or more contrasting yarns. Sarah's going to be working with two different colors. I'm going to be working with two different textures. And you will also need plying thread. So we are going to start by cutting our yarn into lengths. You probably need scissors, huh?
Probably.
Here, I'll cut mine in the middle. Here, you cut some. I bet I could break mine.
How long?
Cut or break. Surprise me. Your yarn into different lengths. I think I'm doing, I don't know, almost a yard. The longer your yardage sections are, the longer your stripes will be. And this is a great technique for if you have several drop spindled balls with itty bitty bits of yardage and you kind of want to create a self-striping yarn and get more yardage from all of them. You could do random yardage, like you could do where every single length is different. You could do every single length exactly the same. You could take 10 different mini balls of yarn and cut them into different lengths.
That would be cool.
Yeah. You could do different singles, like take all your singles that you spun from drop spindling singles and ply them all in a striped yarn to kind of blend them all together. You could also use this with one of the embellished techniques that we're going to be doing in the future with beads or feathers. Yeah, possibilities are endless.
Okay.
Cool. So now that we have our cut sections of single, we are going to tie the first one that we'll be working with into a knot with our plying thread. This is a great practice in attaching yarns with thread as well. So if you were to be plying and your yarn were to accidentally break, you would use this exact same technique to repair broken yarns. Okay. So I've got my plying thread and my yarn tied in a knot, counterclockwise direction. And you could spin these up into a texture if you wanted to. You could do shells or coils or whatever. But I'm just going to start with showing how to thread ply different yarns back to back.
So just all of one and then all of the other?
Yep.
Oh, okay. It's not too hard.
Nope. So when you get to the end of your first yarn stripe, you can attach by pinching the end of the next yarn to it. And this usually works best if you're kind of, your drop spindle's like short. And then while pinching those two ends together, ply around them using your plying thread. So if you think about like all those itty bitty balls of yarn that you make, if you wanted to
That'd
Just
be really
ply
good
the
idea.
yardage together.
Then you don't lose any because you have the thread.
Yeah. It's a great way to not waste yarns that you spin, but really you don't have enough to finish a project. So that's the basics. So now I'm going to play with a little bit of texture as I do this. I'm going to go back to this dark brown wool, ply the end with the pink. Just a second, I've got a little bit of twist, got it tangled up here. We'll just make it work. I'm so done with untangling. Like, life's too short.
True.
Life's too short to untangle yarn. So here's an example. Here's a learning process. I broke my thread because it was tangled up in my yarn. So I'm going to just tie, and I broke my yarn because it was tangled up in my thread. I'm going to tie my threads in a knot. And just join my next color. I'm going to put these, I have a feeling that these are like just getting tangled because they're too close to what my workspace is.
Oh, yep. They're so springy.
Yes. You have scissors right next to you if you end up in a pickle.
Okay. It's working. Huzzah.
Down. Okay, so I'm pinching my two ends together to start my next section. And plying them together with the thread. So as I was saying before, now is the point in time where you can choose to do different textured techniques, like what we were working on before. You can do some coils, you can do shells, you can do stacks. And so as well as going back and forth on color, you can also go back and forth on different textures from this series. So I did like coils with the brown.
Okay.
Pinch the two ends together.
I feel like this could be cool with a colored thread too. So I have like
yes.
the same throughout, but
yes,
whoa.
That's a good idea.
Switching.
You could do like a self-striping multicolored thread or a sparkly thread or yeah, that would be really fun. Especially if you had a ton of yarns that didn't really match.
Yes.
If you had one bold thread to bring them all together, it would give it like cohesiveness.
It's a lot of threads. Two left.
Wow.
I think I barely.
That was a very smart idea. I don't think I was tracking what I cut, so this might be my last one too, because I don't see another purple one.
I should have used the bulky.
That makes sense, though.
Yeah.
Like, I like that you can see exactly gray, white.
Yes.
Yes.
It's not as interesting as shells, but it's very nifty.
Yeah.
Like, I always wondered how exactly to make it.
Yeah, how to make your stash, get yourself more yardage for your stash.
Yes.
Or blend yarns together, or...
Yes.
Experiment with different textures. It's just, yeah, plying stripes.
It's kind of like you could do like a showcase yarn of all
yes.
the different things you know how to do.
Yeah, definitely.
On one
like
thread.
A sampler.
Yes.
Like ply a sampler.
Yes. Okay. Home stretch.
Oh, take your time. Like karaoke night. What would be like a spinning song?
Well, there is a spinning song.
To everything, turn,
yes.
turn, turn. There is a season.
All right.
That's really
stripes.
Great. Yay.
Cool.
I like it.
Okay, me too.
Cool.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you so much for watching and happy spinning.